845. Just walk on the mic, have the B. I feel confident. I feel cocky.
Yeah.
When I'm in my environment, and I know everything in my environment got my back, that's when I shine. I thump my chest. No apprehension.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not shackled by anything. I got my man DJ Air over here. He's riding shotgun. I already know what it is.
I see it.
That's my family. I'm not sure if his mic work. Go ahead, test one of them. See what happens.
What's up, man?
How you been?
I'm good.
Hands down, man. Your opinion. We know him from August Alsina initially.
Absolutely.
He's been around the world now. He's global. And he's working with a good friend of ours right now. Who's the best MC right now
It's not even a question, man.
Say his name.
Man. But, you know, you got to bring it in. You got to finesse this shit, man. Yeah, he's so fucking awesome, man.
Do a little better than that. Yeah, go ahead. You want to finesse?
Nah, man. My brother Nick Grant.
Hottest
MC out, period.
Yeah, yeah.
No debate about it, period. I'm just happy to be a part of the journey, honestly.
Well, you know, since he put out that 88 mixtape and he's come up here and he's made a real big name for himself. We tell his story all the time.
Mm-hmm.
It feels great when you tell these stories. Initially, when I was telling the stories, I was putting a little extra on it and hoping that he catch up with the hype. And you do that through consistency. You know what I mean? And every time he stepped to the plate, he answered. You know, he hit the ball out the park, and he has a new project, Return of the Cool. And I swear to you, man, I've been listening to this project 3 or 4 times, like King Tech and I used to do when we first started the Wake Up Show, and we was listening to a J. Rue the Damager,
mm-hmm.
or we were listening to a Pharoah Monch, or we was listening to a Kool G Rap.
Ooh.
You know, we would dissect people's lyrics, you know, whether it was a Chino XL or whether it was a Heather B. You know, we would dissect people's lyrics and go, oh, my gosh, how did he come up with that? And that's what made the MC special, you know.
Absolutely.
Inability to write catchy tunes mm-hmm. with hooks on them and all of that great thing, those great things as well. I think this guy has done it, man. We watched him evolve to this point. He has his new project. We haven't heard him in a bunch of controversy. He's not fighting with friends he once recorded music with. He's not stepping in a boxing ring. He's
Thank
not
God.
Posting friends pictures of their babies and all that stuff mm-hmm. on Instagram. And he's not sleeping with anybody we know of because
right.
she's famous, you know.
Dick ain't out.
Wow.
Not yet.
Way to paint the picture, Tracy. And he's here with us today, man. You'd be hard-pressed to find another MC that's come out in the past 5 years that's more lyrical than he is. Oh, give it up man. For Nick Grant, ladies
yeah.
and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Thank you for that.
Yeah, I'm trying to put it on.
Oh,
this
man.
We ain't going to see him after this. I already know what's happening.
He out of here?
This is my last bout right here.
I need to come up here every day.
Nick, what's important to you, man? Because when I you know, I've been around you. I've hung out at the house. We've listened to a lot of music.
Yeah.
You weren't soliciting me. You just wanted me to hear music. You know, you wasn't pushing nothing on me. We ate, we drank, we listened to music.
For sure.
And I listened to more songs that's on this project. What's important to you, though, as an artist?
Just living life and being mindful of the things that's around me. Family mm-hmm. is like the most important thing, helping others, inspiring other people, using my voice, having a voice in this business. I'm sorry. Just being positive, man, being a positive influence on these young impressionable kids
mm-hmm.
in these rough times. Yeah.
When he talks, doesn't it sound like he's spitting and shit?
Like,
he's talking bars.
What's important to me is family.
He's talking bars.
You talking bars, right? It sounds like he's in his spitter's yeah. voice. How do you the reason why I asked you, because you're not writing songs that I think. I've had artists come up here and say, if we don't make songs in 5 minutes, then the song is no good. We trash mm-hmm. it. We keep it moving.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I've heard artists say this. I heard producers, and everybody has their method. You've obviously took your time with songs, gone back, looked at lyrics, tweaked them, and
yeah.
right? What is your process?
It's many different things. It's what the beat inspires me to say. It could be a conversation I had with Jason or anybody from my team, or a conversation with my family once again.
Uh-huh.
Might be the experience of being here with you guys and, you know, not taking it for granted and, you know, wanting to be able to come back, you uh-huh. know, and just being inspired. But, you know, sometimes it's, you know, me putting just stuff in my phone and basing the whole verse off of one line and coming up with the rest. You know, just surrounding all the lines around one line for the most part. But for me, man, it's just life and being mindful of the things around me.
You seem really mellow, and I think that was one of the things that stuck out for us first. We met you, what, 2 years ago, maybe three in Atlanta at the Cypher when you came down to Drama Studio, and we were down there for BET. And I follow you on Instagram, and I'm like, I see these pictures, and they pop up, and it's like, oh my gosh, a moment came true. This is another moment that came true. I met this one. I met that one.
Right.
Who would you say was the one person that, because I always thought, I was like, this is Nas. Like, this is Nas coming to us again. Like, who was that one person? When I saw the picture with Nas, I literally, I wrote something on your Instagram. Yeah. So I was like, unbelievable. Who was the one person, though, for you that just kind of was like, wow, bucket list, check?
Yeah, Biggie was like, you know, the reason why I do music, you know, for real. Along with a lot of other people, but he's the reason why I do rap music. I vividly remember, like, being in my mother's living room and seeing the Big Papa video for the first time and just being really inspired. Like, yo, that looks so fun. He made rap look fun. So as a kid, it was like, man, this is what I want to do. At the time, I wasn't, like, writing my own lyrics, but I had to figure that part out. But I didn't know how I was going to do it, but I knew it was going to take some time. But for me, it was Biggie Smalls. And then once I got into it a little deeper, it was Nas and Andre 3000. Nas, because of how he put, like, his words together was, like, amazing. 3000, because of his content. You know, I'm from the South. He's from the South. I could relate to a lot of stuff he was saying. And just, like, his wordplay, my oral demonstration is like clitoral stimulation to the female gender. One of the hardest rap lines ever. You know, so.
Gotta get reminded.
The biggest competition gonna be Sway. Sway gonna come out of nowhere and try to battle you, call you out with your own rhymes.
Like, damn, I'm gonna battle.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take Ryan from the mixtape and battle this one.
So, really, it was just, you know, those three guys.
Yeah.
Along with, like, Joe Sample, Earth, Wind & Fire, Marvin Gaye, Luther Vandross, Take Six, a lot of different things and a lot of different people being played in my household as a kid, so, you know, I gravitated toward it and took what I like.
It doesn't seem like Nick was a kid. Like, it
right.
like landed rapping.
Came out as a man. Exactly.
Childhood.
Out the room with a mic in hand. You know what I want to know? What's, like, your new schedule like? Because every blessing kind of has its own fine print. Because as you go up the ladder, then more people want you. Then more girls are in your DMs. And sometimes it can be hard to just have, like, 5 hours in the studio, I would imagine. But, yeah, what's the difference in 2017 versus what year was it when we first met?
2015.
Yeah.
October, actually. Wow. Yeah.
Damn.
October 2015.
It's been that long,
yeah.
Bro.
Yeah.
Wow.
These guys keep me very busy, man. So I'm just enjoying the ride. Tunnel vision. I know a lot of different things and a lot of different distractions are going to happen. But for me, it's all about the music and the art. Like, I love this more than all of the outside things. You
good.
Know?
So, but the biggest, like, some of the up and coming artists aren't as lyrical as you. You know, whether you're talking about.
And you know this.
Yeah. Everybody at the BET Awards. How about that? I'm joking.
Damn.
I'm joking. The Cypress are crazy. What does your audience say to you? Like, the younger, you know, you have a young audience, but they're listening. They're able to listen to a variety of music. It might be something with a style like a 21 Savage that's not so much, you know, lyrical as yours, but impactful. A lot of folks are following 21 Savage or Kodak Black. They don't rap like you, but they got the attention of the audience right now. What does your audience say to you?
They appreciate it, you know, in a time where, like I always say, it's about substance abuse rather than having substance in your music. So they just appreciate it, man. But, you know, I enjoy all of it. You know, I love Future, I love Nas, but I also love Tribe and I love 21 Savage. I love different things. I feel like you need all of that just for balance. You don't wake up every day feeling the same way. So, you know, it's good to have all of it. It's just when certain things overpower the culture, you know, is when we get lost.
The single that you're pushing,
it
doesn't necessarily sound. Look, what were you going for with the sound? Because it feels like we were just watching Amadi, the video, and I felt like it was, I was in a scene of Idlewild.
Right.
Almost.
Wow.
What were you going for? Because the sound doesn't sound like anything to me. And y'all played it for me at Jason's house.
Yeah.
When I was sneaking muffins out of his cabinet and he didn't even
Depot?
Man, you gotta see his house. He didn't notice. It seemed like something strategic. Yeah. How did you want to introduce yourself to the audience?
I can say about the Idlewild Field was directed by Brian Barber, who shot the Idlewild.
Oh,
yeah, 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 that was the I. Where's the I button? I need that stunt button.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was, that's probably the reason why you got that feel. But you know, my mother would tell me like, I love your music, but it's just so much cursing. So for me, my attachment to that record was making something she could dance to without, you know, having to cut out certain words. But we were just in L.A. with I was in L.A. with Jason Jeter, and the beat came on. Producer by the name of Kareem Riggins played it for us. And, you know, me and Jason just looked at each other. Then he texted me, like, when we left the studio that night, like, yo, this could be a big record. So took it back to Atlanta, finished it. Jesse from Watch the Duck came through. Actually, Jesse recorded his hook in L.A., mm-hmm. and I took my verses back to Atlanta, recorded it there, and came out dope.
You got to, for those who don't know, explain Watch the Duck. Right. Who are Watch the Duck?
Oh, man, very unique individuals, man. Jesse, who's like, you know, a very soulful guy, very unique artist, man, talented, gifted, and, you know, he's looking forward to a very big year for himself as well.
Yeah, so, dope. Yeah, it's dope, man. Look, I hope we're going to ask more questions, open up the phone lines, but can you perform a song live for us?
Absolutely.
Did they tell you that DJ Air is here for a reason?
Yeah, I'm ready, man. Yeah. What we doing?
Air hit me, said, I'm going to get him to perform live. Sway. I'm gonna get him. I said, all right, man, whatever. Whatever Nick wants to do. All right, let's do it, man. Sway in the morning, Shade 45, 888-742-3345.
Yeah.
Somebody tell them niggas that I'm legendary. We gon' check them first like the secretary. Leap the competition 29th of February. This double limb is all I need, I think I'm Method Mary bouncing. I peel off like a dead nigga. Shoot a do it himself, boy, he Blair with you. Blood spilling over beef, I'm a rare nigga. And we don't run from nothing less the fans with you. How you want it? This that 96 Pac. Never met a nan, other nigga this hot. Paint game dope, scribble to my wrist lock. Niggas ballin' thinking shit is sweet. Chris Bosh, boy bouncing. You gotta catch those lines. Tell a broke nigga, hold up that depressed hoe sign. She won't dick it, I'ma nail it, not the press on con. Baby girl, throw it back like it's West Coast time and get it.
Hot damn.
Nick Grant, yo.
Money, boy, the shit ain't in the bag.
You know what this
girl
is.
Money,
it's MC Nightmare. Check it, we bouncing.
Food for the soul, real nigga ingredient. Never was a hater, baby, that shit look too tedious. Come through wavy and they gon' do you the greasiest. Kids slide up on you like pajamas with the feet in them. Cold minded, she ain't messing with no cheap nigga. My biggest fear is that you treating me like these niggas. Got a PhD and she like the weed lit up. Ass fat, she don't waste much like a cheap nigga bouncing. My outfit scream murderer. Yeah, I'm showing out, roll the curtains up. Baby blue Jordan, now I think I should hit Gerber up. Going harder than Laura letting Urkel fuck. I thought I told you that it's all about the moolah. Know I keep that thing like when Lauren dropped doo-wop. Tell them niggas cool out before they hear that booyah. Party animal, it's like when Meech brought the zoo out. Bouncing.
Y'all know what this is. Dawn of a new era. You ain't got bars, you ain't going far. You know why? Bouncing. Way in the morning. Nick Grant. Return of the cool. I can talk this shit because I'm about this shit. Bouncing. Yeah. Oh, this is good shit talking about right here. We talked about what we gonna do in 2017. We bouncing on all these whack MCs. We bouncing. Cause we hate you. We're bouncing. You ain't got bars. Your team is lying to you. Bouncing. Hey, Grant, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna
thank you for that.
Come back. Hold on. I gotta take a breather. We're gonna come back. Open up the phone lines from Nick Grant.
Yeah, yeah.
888-742-3345. Yo, oh, drop a beat on him.
More of the Sway in the Morning concert series on Shade 45.
And now making his network television debut with a special medley of Love and Get Up. Please welcome Nick Grant featuring Watch the Duck.
Yeah, that's Stephen Colbert's show. He started on Sway in the Morning and he ended up on Stephen Colbert's show. He's here with us right now, the one and only Nick Grant, man.
Yeah.
Yo, I saw when you posted your experience with Stephen Colbert. First of all, congratulations.
Yeah. Nah, thank you, man. Appreciate you.
You have done nothing to compromise your integrity along your journey. And so thank when you're able to make it to those mainstream platforms like this, the Colbert Show,
right,
that means one of us made it. And that sends a message to other artists. You don't have to change who you are to make it to the big time. But you also said, man, this is now, I've experienced a great time with one of my new best friends, Stephen Colbert. You actually, you know, I don't know how Jay and Amir took this, you know, but, you know, dudes who stood with you while you were broke. But, now Colbert is new. You didn't mention Heather either.
I think they want that.
Okay. What was that experience like, though? What was like when you walked in the building? Were you nervous? Like, walk us through that.
Man, I feel like if you don't get nervous, this ain't for you.
Yeah.
You know, for me, like, I just remember, like, writing rhymes in my room, just being hungry and saving money and writing rhymes that nobody in the world could hear, just my friends, you mean? And to be on that platform last night, and, you know, even like, you know, when I was here for, like, the first time, that was, like, the greatest feeling ever.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, to get to that platform and reach these platforms, man, is, like, priceless. You can't pay for that, you know?
What's changed in your life? Like, you was writing rhymes in your room. Now where do you write your rhymes? Where do you live?
I still write them in a room.
It's still in a room?
It's still in a room. It's just...
A different room?
Life is... Yeah, different room. Life is just a little different.
No more futons. A futon is... Yo, every MC had got a futon story to tell. That futon got real.
I'd rather sleep on the floor.
No, that ball? Woo!
Are you doing, like, other businesses or making business decisions beyond the music? Like, you know, are you investing in companies or what else are you doing?
Right now, it's still early for me, so I'm just looking out for my family and just making sure they're straight and living. But, you know, once things start really changing, I'm looking to do a few things. Yeah.
Okay.
For sure.
So if you had a beef, would you do a boxing match?
Nah, I'm not doing no boxing
matches. Okay, great. Good. Good to know. All right, Nick Grant. Fling's on the line from Florida. That was a trick question. Fling, good
what's
morning.
What's the deal, though?
Hey, what's going on?
All right, what's poppin', y'all? Fling, what's popping with you? Go ahead.
All right, so the first song on the tape, the first song on the track, he said, money is the root of all evil that destroyed the family tree. All right, now that shit blew my motherfucking mind, right? So I posted it on Facebook, and my homeboy, who's a rapper too, started arguing with me, telling me it wasn't a good line. I said, bro, you must be out your mind. We literally almost threw hands over that shit. Like, that shit, it blew my fucking mind. That shit was perfect.
Thank you, man. I appreciate you for that.
But anytime, see, Fling, the point, like, anytime you got music that's so provocative that it make you think and have you arguing over a lyric.
I want to fight.
Yeah, that's good. Nick's doing his job. Pick up the project, Return of the Cool. It's on iTunes now, okay?
I got that jump twice.
Damn, I got it twice, man. All right.
Appreciate you, man.
Thank you,
man. Go get another one.
Why would he buy it twice? All right, Keith is in Boston.
Right.
Go ahead, Keith.
Give it to his man.
Hey, what's up, Nick?
Yeah. What's going on, man? How you feeling?
I'm feeling great, man. I'm glad you dropped that new album. I became a fan from listening to Sway in the Morning.
Yeah.
I try to put everybody on the Nick Grant, man. I even had them pull you up on YouTube in the barbershop. I had the barbershop stopped in the hood so everybody can hear that shit.
Oh, man, nice. Appreciate you for that, man. Thank you.
Hey, man, support him, man. Let's.
I do, man. I got that. I've been listening to Bouncing all weekend.
That's what's up, man. That's Bouncing, nice. That's a joint, man. Josh in Providence. What up, Josh?
What's up, Joshua?
Yo, this is exactly why I listen to Sway. To find people like Nick Grant. Nick, you are like Pac, Biggie, Rakim. Fuck, let me add some new people in. Let's say Savage 21. I'll throw in some futuristic. I'll even throw in some Beast because you are fucking killing it. Thank you.
Thank you, man. I appreciate you.
I like you know that Savage 21 here, Josh.
Dude, it's fire.
All right, let's go to Coco. Coco, what's up? She in the shies.
Coco.
What's happening, Sway? I call every day. I never get through, and I'm through, and I'm so happy to speak to you guys.
Hey, man, listen, I'm happy you made it. You happy? I'm happy. And then I'm happy you made it with Nick, too, Nick Grant.
Yeah, me too, because, look, bro, when I first checked out The Jungle, that's when I was like, okay, I got to find out about this guy.
Dope.
And, man, bro, hey, bro, he's been blowing my mind ever since. He says so much stuff. It's like old school shit because he says so much. It's not one line in the song. It's plenty lines in the song. Overton Living Single, bro, Hey, I listened to the whole thing like a couple times, man. The man is dope.
Thank you, man.
It's refreshing. Cold, it's cold. So refreshing, bro.
You're a citizen.
Oh, yeah, Sway.
Yes.
Firehouse is shut down, Sway. We ain't doing that no more out
but,
here.
But it was out there, right, Coco?
Yeah. It was a house joint, but yeah.
I used to go to a house club called the Firehouse in Chicago years ago. Right. Yeah.
Yeah, that's
where I first met Shauna.
Sway don't be having no proof of a lot of stuff, so we don't believe his stories. He need more people, and then the people call.
And they call. Yeah. I throw it out there. They call. They stand by me, HB.
All right.
We do this thing called Lyrical Breakdown. And there's a couple of the lyrics I wanted to see if we could get some insight before we have you perform another song. Nick Grant is here, 888-742-3345 is Lyrical Breakdown.
I don't get it.
What exactly don't you get?
Breaking down the lyrics you may not understand.
What the hell did you just say?
It's the Lyrical Breakdown.
I can break it down like whatever you want.
On Sway in the Morning.
You know, this was just a fun song, Heather. Like, mm-hmm. Nick writes in a way that if you read his raps, you feel like you're a great rapper.
Mm.
All right? I'm going to demonstrate and see if he could explain some of them, some of the lyrics. This song is called Gotta Be More.
Okay.
And it's featuring BJ the Chicago Kid.
Love BJ.
You know, you got a lot of features on it. Well, not a whole lot, but you got some great features on this project, but BJ the Chicago Kid is also like you, somebody who came up on the show early. Gotta be more.
Yes.
First one. Niggas ain't been rapping lately. I guess I'm trapped in the 80s. Ain't fly enough if the fascist statements don't make you hate me. I took niggas ain't been rapping lately as your assessment of what you're seeing in the cesspool of MCs that we live in today. Is that am I accurate with that?
Absolutely. I feel like I'm in the time. I feel like, you know, the Kendricks and the Coles, you know, they're so up here, they're not going. They inspire me for sure, but, you know, I use them to kind of feed off and to kind of make me better as far as the new generation of MCs. But other than that, I got to go back 20 years to listen to somebody else to inspire me. Like, it's not a lot of people that inspire me current day, so.
Damn.
It's like, man, if I grew up in the 90s, it was Pac, Biggie, Nas, Jay, you know, all these people. If I was out in the 90s, I'm sorry, and I grew up. If I was out in the 90s and you know, in the game and had my foot in the game in the 90s, I would have so many people to feed off that I feel like I would be better as an MC. But, you know, right now, niggas ain't been rapping lately.
Ain't been rapping. That's why he feels like he's trapped in the 80s.
Yeah.
Ain't flying off the fascist statements don't make you hate me.
Yeah.
And when you walked in, I've always looked you. I give you the one over whenever you walk up because you always throwing these subtleties in your fashion, man.
Yeah.
You a fashion guy?
Yeah, absolutely, man. I like little different things. Junior with Watanabe, which my man put me on. Capital, Vintage Heavy, which is his brand.
Okay.
He's
making you wear all his stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. That's cool.
You know what?
All right. Looking up to drug czars, same ones who sold my mother raw.
Yeah.
Your mother was on drugs?
Absolutely. I think I mentioned that like the second time I was up here.
You did. So she's off drugs.
Yeah, she's off drugs.
Yeah.
Right now. So yeah, which is a blessing. But the same people that I would look up to that would have all this money in my neighborhood were the same people that, same types of people that was selling my mother drugs in the street. So, you know, it was like a journey to kind of get, train my mind to like, you know, get out of that, get out of that thought process of, you know, materialism and, you know, because these people are the same people that is killing people you love, killing people you love. So it's like, you know, it was a struggle, but it's great now.
You don't look up to drug dealers no more?
Fashion-wise.
Fashion-wise?
Hence the song Drug Lord Couture.
Drug Lord Couture. One of the second song on the project. Die quick as the culture if we don't. Okay. Looking up to drugs are same ones who sold my mother raw. Die quick as the culture if we don't evolve.
That's like an attachment to the previous line, which is, you know, I don't want to say I would kill you, but the same people that was selling my mother drugs, it made me so furious that I was looking up to you and you disappointed me in that way. Not saying that, you know, you meant to do that, but I would kill you. Quick as the culture, you know, a little wordplay. Mm-hmm. Quick as the culture if we don't evolve as MC. So it's kind of two gems in one. Yeah.
Yo, you see what I mean?
Power right. Power
I can say every line, watch, I'm just going to jump. Pray for my niggas, live long, no time for silly rappers. They two lame clicks. Oh, well, I didn't do that right.
Just try again. It's
Diamonds
nice.
Looking pissed on. Picking bitches like I'm Frankie Lemon. Nigga wants one. Pray my niggas live long. No time for silly rappers and they lame clicks. Nah, man, listen. You could go through this whole album, man. Yeah. I got stuck on Sometimes. And then I went to Drug man. Lord Couture. And then I went to Bouncing. And
I love
it. Was it P.I.P.? What is it?
P.P.I.P.
What does that mean, man?
You ready? Pussy print and pink panties.
Pussy, what? Say that again?
Hey.
Pussy, what's that? Eris, can you repeat that? You can't
I'm
even say
I'm gonna let Nick
say it again.
Pussy print and pink panties.
Your grandmother like that?
Right. Right. That's the favorite.
All right. This is what I want to do, man. Give this man a round of applause for writing lyrics that got us moving. I want to end the interview with one more song, but sure. You know, this is a celebration, man. Return of the Cool.
Thank you, man.
A guy that's good for the culture, you know. Right. And I say you keep us inspired.
Keep doing.
I look
Likewise.
In the face of many Likewise. MCs and. Yeah. I'm looking at you the same way I remember Nas first came on or Jay first came on, and nobody started off where they are. It was all a journey, and I'm curious to see where your journey takes you.
Nah, man, I just thank you guys for the platform and just letting me tell my story, you know.
Absolutely. You
can't pay for that. It's priceless. I appreciate it.
But what's your relationship status like?
Oh, damn.
Still?
Tunnel vision. Single.
Okay. What was the pink? Pussy. What is it called?
Pussy print and pink panties.
What you know about that? If you single, are you celibate?
No, I'm not celibate.
Okay.
Just making requests.
He said that with disgust.
Celibacy is fine.
With like celibate, right?
Let me live, Sway. That's what he's trying to say to you on the you says to return to the cool nigga. Let me live.
Let him live,
man. Let him live.
All right. Yeah, I just don't want the lyrics. I've seen Coochie mess up many rap careers.
Yeah,
I'm just saying. I just want him to stay focused. Yeah. I want the good music, not the good gossip. All right.
Be the babies, not the coochie. You got to pull out.
Right?
Heather, what? You can't shoot up the club, y'all. Just pull out. It's the babies. It's the alimony.
Gosh.
It's a trickle-down effect. Tracy, trying to get you game.
Nick could get stressed out. He got a baby on the way.
Two babies.
What happened, rapper? You don't want that.
Sit on a preview of Love & Hip Hop Atlanta.
And Maury.
Call her up, man. Be coming on Sway in the Morning, crying. I seen dudes.
I'm big grandbaby,
Nick, you got a song for us, man?
Yeah,
you do one
more?
Let's do it.
One more.
What we gonna do?
Let's do Gotta Be More.
Let's do it, man. That's the one we
wanna do. You wanna do Gotta Be More? That's how you know we live, right?
Yeah. It's DJ Era.
Say 45, Sway in the Morning. Nick Grant's in the building, Return of the Cool. Out now, get that DJ Era. Niggas ain't been rapping lately. Yes, I'm trapped in the 80s. Ain't fly enough if the fashion statements don't make you hate me. Looking up the drug czars, same ones who sold my mother raw. Die quick as the culture if we don't evolve. Can never hide the scars. I'm front with pistols, bark like a pit of dogs. Nigga, shit gets hard. Thirsty bitches even wanna sip the tears from dons. Rich rap, skin black as Norman Lear sitcoms. Diamonds looking pissed on. Picking women like I'm Frankie Lyman. Nigga, which one? Pray my niggas live long. No time for silly rappers and they two lame clicks. For the record, we deeper than the Wu-Tang hit. My tribe took me out the ghetto, found a new lane quick. At any moment, they gon' hit me with that you change shit. More honesty than Richard Pryor comedy. I don't know where I'ma be when Obama leave. Gotta be more, more, more.
Said there's gotta be more. Yeah, baby. Said there's gotta be more.
Return of the Cool Nick Grant.
Out now.
The Culture Republic. DJ Era. On the ones and twos.
Check.
Yo, Nick, what you gon' say to him?
I'm Gil Scott Heroin. Here to give America a dose of their own medicine. Who I ain't better than, you should watch who you bet against. Exposed hearts of jealous men. Predator felon, mama's bestie molested them. Killers vanish cause fans tamper with evidence. Long as the soul's wealthy, we cool cause we were never rich. Sweat me like fair pressure, was left for dead. Sorry I'm misleading, Miss Lady. All I wanted was head, sipping wine imported. My rhyme style is gorgeous. Buy my money, this is worse than Sally Mae extortion. Don't know what's real, it's like I'm looking through the eyes of orphans. The newest bins turning like some disappointed corpses. Old head stories of how they was the shit in they day. The world bleeds, menstrual shows, get tickets today. 200 on the car dash with a trunk full of yay. Life's good, no more reruns of minimum wage. Gotta be more,
DJ,
more, more.
Said there's gotta be more.
That's Nick Grant on these lyrics.
Said there's
gotta be more.
He ain't read them off the phone either. He memorized them. That's because he wrote them.
Yeah.
You write them, you decide them. Mix for that shit.
Still could pull a motto with no dollar to my name. A nation in debt, and here we are begging for change. All for nothing, another brother slain. Death is a tough exchange. Trump even running game. All aboard the coon train. Clown Sambo painted faces. You frontin' so embarrassing. Tap dancing for whitey. Get you nothing but a penny for your thoughts. If all times are good, do you know who you really are? I need the bad times. Adversity get you far. This verse is a key of all. Babies die young. Remember you via the project wall. My generation needs a red fox. Selena Horn. Feel like I'm the one to put us on top where we belong. Walking Fred Hampton agenda. I'm too attentive. My shit is poison to these rap pretenders who swear they trap but never seen a pack. This epidemic of twisting facts. Still we celebrate your backwards image. You gotta be more, more.
Said there's gotta be more. Said there's gotta be more.
DJ Era on those turntables, he knows what he's doing. Yo, DJ doesn't. Nick Grant on that mic, he knows what he's doing. Yo, MC doesn't.
Yeah.
I like that. That's hip hop in the drawing form 2017. Moving on, Nick Grant.
Thank you, man.
Damn, man, you see what I'm talking? This is how I grew up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You got me being my original self listening to your music. Just nah, so if man, you want to know that era that inspires you, right. We were there with the architects.
I already know.
That was putting them building blocks down. It was this kind of energy that helped gave us those brainstorms, that intuitiveness,
right.
That intuition, that determination, that drive. And seeing people were exceptional like you with the craft.
Thank you, man.
Yeah. Make you want to be exceptional. That's why I'm talking shit like I'm 18 again.
Man, appreciate you.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Feel good. That's what I was like, man. When I was 18.
Yeah.
I talk shit now. Imagine when I was 18.
Right.
All right?
Savage.
Yeah. You already know. Nick, proud of you, man.
Thank you,
great
man.
Work.
Thank
proud
you.
Of the whole
nah,
team, man.
I appreciate you, man. Thank
proud
you
of the
so
whole
much.
Team.
For real. Thank
all
you.
Right. Man, y'all can listen back to this. Go to SiriusXM.com/on-demand. And it will be posted on Sway's Universe tomorrow. Next, Ron Howard, one of the most impactful people, iconic figures in Hollywood. His daughter is coming up to the show. Bryce Howard will be up next. You want to talk with her? 888-742-3345.
It's Sway in the Morning, only on Shade 45.